Welcome to Sports Psychology 101. I'm Jake.
I'm Malik.
And I'm Austin.
And on today's episode, we're going to talk about how anxiety impacts sport performance based on an article by Mark Oten titled Choking vs. Clutch Performance, a study of sport performance under pressure.
This article attempts to explain the phenomenon by which an athlete either chokes or has a clutch performance while under pressure. A clutch performance is defined as any increment or superior performance while under pressure, whereas choking is defined as any decrement or inferior performance while under pressure.
Now, in order to complete the task, participants are required to shoot 15 free throws without having no pressure, then 50 more after they were being told that their free throws were going to be recorded and used by a psychology professor. Now, questionnaires and tasks were filled out by the participants before, during, and after their shots in order to assess their levels of anxiety, self-consciousness, reliance on implicit knowledge, and reinvestment. Now, after the data was recorded, 128 participants had improved performances under pressure, while 60 participants did indeed choke under pressure, and another 13 scored identically both times. Pearson
mishandled the puck. An example of a clutch performer would be Justin Williams, who is known as Mr. Game 7 due to his amazing statistics recorded in Game 7 throughout his career.
There, Tanner Pearson thought he had a chance to keep going on the 3-on-2, but the puck just goes off the stick of Dan Girardi, turns it over, Mike Richards to...
An example of a team that choked would be the Toronto Maple Leafs in 2012, who blew a 4-1 lead in Game 7 in the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs to the Boston Bruins, who came back to win the series in overtime.
This model summarizes the findings of the study. High amounts of sport and self-confidence leads to perceived control of a task. When an athlete has perceived control, as well as reliance on implicit knowledge, they are more likely to have a clutch performance. Sport confidence was found to lead to increased self-confidence and perceived control, but not to lower anxiety. Also, expertise has a direct positive relationship with self-confidence and sport confidence, which leads to clutch performance. Higher reinvestment scores leads to increased cognitive and somatic anxiety, which results in self-focus. Self-focus, along with dependence on explicit knowledge, increases the probability the athlete will choke.
Here are a few ways that this information can help athletes perform better while under pressure. Coaches must ensure their athletes avoid reinvestment, which is the redistribution of focus to the mechanics of a task. They must avoid this because it leads to anxiety. To avoid this, coaches must instruct their players in practice, but be supportive and encouraging in games. This way, players feel that they have what it takes to succeed and do not feel the need to reinvest.
Coaches must train athletes to develop their sport confidence and perceive control over a sport-specific task. Although this can be very difficult because self-confidence comes mostly from internal sources, ways a coach can help develop these skills include instructing athletes to use methods such as imagery, teach them that they are in control, and an athlete will be more confident as they see improvement.
As an athlete, having a higher perceived control can help an athlete better their performance while under pressure. Perceived control can be increased by having higher self-confidence and relying on implicit knowledge of a skill rather than explicit. This transpires to being good at a skill based on modifications that one has learned through personal experience rather than being told what to do.
Okay, time to work on my free throws. Make sure I follow through. Oh, I think I followed through too much to the left that time. Let me try again. There we go.
Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope this helped. I'm Jake.
I'm Austin.
And I'm Malik. And be sure to tune into our channel next week for our latest episode.